Okay, so here I am in North Carolina, and this is a platform that we're going to be using for this symposium. And we have a lot of open area here, and this place is just absolutely phenomenal. This is the headquarters of where we will be for 7 days. Some people are only coming for two. Some people coming for five. So it gives you a good idea of what this place looks like from the outside here. But we're gonna be doing some barbecues, some campfires, roasting marshmallows, s'mores, all kinds of stuff. But we are going to be basically living and breathing and working dogs for 7 days here. So this is the front part. As you can see, this is pretty good size. Okay, so this will be the classroom. This is really awesome. And chairs and tables will be here. There'll be a big screen covering that up there. And then we have our section of Northwest Naturals for treats for all the participants. This area right here will be Maddie's area doing photography. We have three climate control rooms like this that dogs will be able to go in. Those are nice and comfortable. We're gonna set up a couple of treadmills here. And this is what it looks like through the back. And there's my home for the next 7 days when I come back. Pop through here. So you can see we're just getting all this stuff ready. We've got full shower, bathroom, just picking things up, cleaning up. We're getting things stowed. And then this is gonna be our fit pause area. So everything's gonna be set up in here for the fit pause. Refrigerator, we got a microwave, we've got coffee maker, we've got Instapot, we've got toaster, we've got all kinds of stuff, and this is where that'll be gone. But this is where we're gonna have all the fit pause stuff. And then we pop out here. And we have dogs doing some gardening. Are you gardening? Yes, are you gardening?
Yes, she's helping.
Are you helping? Okay, that's a good stick. You're doing an amazing job of communicating with her with your body and your hands and your feet. But when she does it on her own, make sure you make a very strong ah, because okay. She does do that on her own.
She jumped her gun. That
yeah.
Time.
See if you can get that front on the 22-inch pad and then shift your body to get her rear onto that 360.
So do it. separately?
Yeah, so you're gonna, when you shift your weight, you're gonna get her to jump on that 22 inch pad. And then her rear feet are gonna be next to the 360. So then shift your body to see if you can get her rear onto that 360. Okay. Okay, so from there you're gonna shift to get her rear onto that 360. Perfect. That's awesome. Yeah, she's extremely responsive. Okay, now shift to get her rear on the 22 inch. Beautiful. Try to work her further away. Watch your eye contact because she's looking at your eyes and we want her to follow your body.
I look right at her.
Yep.
Good girl. I don't have enough room.
You do. So she's really doing well with you close. The next step is to get further away so you can be out at that 6 foot lead and have her watching your body. But your eye contact will throw that off.
Okay, back up.
That looks really good. Okay, so split the difference in half, and then eventually you want to get it so you're at the end of that 6 foot lead and she's reading your body.
Okay, that's a good thing to know.
Yeah.
That was kind of my inclination.
Mm-hmm. Watch those eyes because she'll miss a signal from your body if she's looking at your eyes. There, that's better.
Good, yes.
That's better.
Good.
See, she's watching your body more when you're not looking at her.
I tried to keep my eye on her rear, on her tail.
Yeah. Be careful with the no when she's doing what you're telling her to do. Because you may think you're telling her something, but when you went like that, she actually responded correctly to what you just asked her.
Okay.
So you gotta be careful.
I see it in my mind now.
Yeah. She can't really give her a correction for doing what you asked her to do. That's better. Better. Nice and slow. And there it is, beautiful. Quick movements, she'll only catch part of that.
So
slow it down.
Slow it down.
Yeah, because like what you have in your head, you're going like this, but when you're further away, it's almost like you're starting over.
Okay.
So you want to just slowly.
So I felt that was a little slower than last.
Yeah, that last one, and it worked great. So, but if you go too quickly, she's going to see that first part of the communication, and then she's gonna take over from there.
Okay. Back. See, to me that feels like a crush. Like, I'm pushing back and she's coming forward.
No, that's not a correction.
I'm pushing back and she's coming forward.
Okay, so if you're standing up straight, don't have your palm like this, like you've got it. Have it like that. So it's a wall.
Okay.
like this, straight out. No, see, don't curve your fingers like this. Make it a very distinct, okay, Mary, make it a very distinct, there, that's it. Yes, that's good, that's good. See, yes. That's perfect.
My hand is curved.
Right, but you gotta get those fingers straight because if you're like this, that's not a signal.
I was trying to hold a treat and do it and I can't.
No, you can hold the treat in your other hand. Okay, so you got it, but your hand should be over, crossed over on the other side of your body more, because what's happening is you want to use your body and your hand. And when you put your hand way over to the side, see how more effective that is? Because now you're using your body and your hand. But if you have it too far to the left, you're losing all your body communication.
Okay.
Beautiful. See, that is so much better there.
Oh.
Watch your eyes. Be consistent with the app. That's perfect. Beautiful. Be careful of a double signal. Beautiful. That was really nice. That's awesome. Beautiful.
Yes.
Very nice. Good reward timing on that too.
Good.
Very nice. You know, that would probably be a good opportunity for position 3 practice. Get her on a 3/4, tell her to stay, throw the piece of bait. Yeah.
Stay.
And it needs to be directly in line in front of her. And you get off to the side. And then release her.
Yes.
Yeah, that would be great to train position three.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense to me.
She keeps getting wild every time she does.
Can I correct her?
Yeah, do a head straight. Move slower with her. No, I work through this. Get her to calm down for a little bit, then put her in the crate.
Okay, I'm here. Here.
There you go.
Here. Yes.
Do another head straight. Take her over to the 360. And slow your motions down.
Okay.
was good. That was good. That's good. Go ahead straight on the 360. And then put her in a crate. That's awesome. Okay, crate. Now remember, with a puppy, you have to get him to do something, reward, do something, reward, do something, reward. Can't go several steps without a reward, because then she starts to lose interest and she starts looking for other things. So her body language to tell you that you're not rewarding her quick enough is when she's losing interest and she's starting to look for other stuff.
It's good to have a reminder because I get so focused on
that. Yep. Okay, that was good. Reward, good.
Good.
Very good.
Good.
Now you see the focus come back. Great focus there.
Good.
Beautiful. So she's learning the language and she's learning that she gets rewarded. Very nice.
Good.
Beautiful. See, she's responding amazing now.
Good. Good girl. Maddie.
Okay, reward. You have her kind of on a roll right now, so you got to keep that momentum going. Very nice. I would take her maybe over to the 360s or another obstacle, do some more good focus, and then put her up.
Good girl. Can I try the feet?
Yeah.
This one.
nice. That was awesome.
Good. Yeah, I think she can do this.
I'd get a back foot and then put her up. Almost, almost.
Good. Yes.
Yes.
Good girl. Good girl. Yeah. Good girl.
Okay, put her up quick. That was awesome.